How's it going? Jeff here at Deep Cycle Battery. Today we're going to talk to you about golf cart battery charging, and help you troubleshoot what's going on with your golf cart. If you've noticed that your batteries that, let's say, are not that old are diminishing in range, and you keep trying to plug them in the charger and you still aren't getting the range that you expected, I want you to go out and take a look at the charger that you are using. There's a lot of changes today in charger technology, and people wrongly assume that the batteries are just being made inferior. But what has happened is the invention of what they call a high frequency style charger. If you are using a charger that has a heat sink or these fins on top of it, it's a low weight charger, then this video might help you. If I remember in the old days that chargers used to be the big black or silver box and they weighed a ton, and you would plug in the golf cart and it would get done charging in about 6 to 8 hours depending on what the batteries were. Well, nowadays the companies like EasyGo and I think Club Car, they're sending out these chargers that are called high frequency style chargers. They are more energy efficient, but the problem is the batteries are not receiving a full state of charge like you might assume they are. Now, on these style chargers, if you see it has a green light, what you and I would assume is when the light is green after a full range of charge that the batteries are 100% charged. That is not the case. So you go out, take the golf cart, whether it's street legal or you can play some golf, and you take it out and you think it's got a full charge and it dies prematurely, I want you to purchase a hydrometer. It's a battery hydrometer. We sell them for 12 bucks. When your charger, I want you to verify. When your charger, if you have a charger like this and it tells you that the batteries are 100% charged, use a hydrometer. The hydrometer has a needle that goes from low to middle to high. It'll tell you the battery state of charge. Verify. If the charger is telling you and the batteries are not, then you know your chart. Then this video is going to explain what's going on with the charger. This charger right here is made by Quick Charge. We love their chargers. They're the heavy transformer wound copper based. They get the job done. So I'm going to use the RXV as this scenario. You have in the 48 volt EasyGo RXV, which this charger was built for, you have four 12 volt batteries. The capacity is 150 amp hours. So you have to charge 150 amp hours, okay? So when you take your golf cart, and let's say you do 18 rounds of golf or you go street legal and you're good, and you take them down to 50%, no more than 50% depth of discharge, that's gonna leave you 75 amp hours that you need to replace with your charger, okay? So the screen's gonna show you the math. So you wanna replace 75 amp hours. We recharge batteries to 110%. So that means we need to replace 82.5 amp hours. Okay, you with me? In this charger example, 82.5 amp hours is gonna be done with a 48 volt charger that's 13 amps. This is a 13 amp charger. And if all 13 amps are available, then it's gonna take 6.5 hours to recharge your batteries. Now, quick note, when your batteries are done charging, they're hot. You wanna let them cool for at least 2 hours. Why is that? If you jump in a golf cart that just got done finished charging with batteries that are hot and you hit the gas pedal, you're going to send a very destructive, I don't know the actual chemical process, but you're gonna send a destructive wave into that battery when the lead oxide on that plate is still soft, and you're gonna fracture and really cripple your battery's ability to sustain. So let batteries cool down at least 2 hours after charge. Well, if you've been doing this for a little while, you know that when you charge batteries, that heat is created. And if you put a hand on a charger or even the battery, you can see it's getting hot. If you dissect these high frequency style chargers, it's a green computer board in here. What happens when computers, electronics get hot? They reduce their output, okay? Their efficiency, there's losses. So now when this charger is halfway through, let's say, its process, and you lose 50% of its output, that now means you're trying to charge with 6.5 amps. And it started with 13, now it's 6.5. So now, let's do the math. 82.5 amp hours divided by 6.5 amps of charging time, it's gonna take you 12 and a half hours to recharge your batteries. And then you have a 2 hour window to let them cool down. So 14, 15 hours. Most people like to hit their golf cart in the morning. Charger's not done. So you can see where we're finding the disconnect here. In this example, this is a 15 amp 48 volt charger. And when it gets hot, because it will also get hot, its efficiency is 95%. So in the math, at 82.5 amp hours of battery, that's at 50% depth of discharge, it would take us 5.5 hours if all 15 amps are available. But when it gets hot, it's gonna have a little bit loss, but look at the loss, it's only 14.5. So 82.5 amp hours divided by 14.5 amps of charge, it's gonna take us 6 hours. You can see why when we replace customers' chargers, we're replacing them with either the Quick Charge or even the Lester. The old PowerWise is phenomenal. That technology is getting the job done. I really hope this helps you figure out, and we've helped customers that bought brand new batteries and they're using this kind of charger and they're just not getting the range. So the takeaway is check your charger output and look at the hydrometer, get one, and verify the state of charge. I hope that helps you. This is Jeff at Deep Cycle Battery San Diego. Take care. Talk to you soon.